Hello and welcome back to MBV. I'm Casper, and today we're going to take advantage of this nice weather here in Oregon to finally follow up on the Fast EFI and Bluetooth distributor setup on this 280Z. As you can tell from the blown out image, it's actually nice weather here in Oregon for once, so I'm taking full advantage of the sun. So I apologize in advance if my pasty complexion blinds you or destroys my camera. But we're finally going to get back to something that's been much requested in the comments section and my email, which is the follow-up on the Fast EFI and Bluetooth distributor setup on the 280Z project. So this car has the EZ EFI installation available from Z Depot, as well as the 123 ignition Bluetooth distributor setup. Now, if I can get through this little demonstration out here without my cat driving me insane, because he really wants attention at the moment, I will give you the quick rundown of the installation, the current settings I have on the timing curves, as well as the Fast EFI setup, and then discuss the few issues that I've encountered and solved on this setup so far. So let's go ahead and get the car started and take a look. Now obviously this is a warm start because I just drove home from work, which is why I'm still all dressed up and not in regular shop clothes. But I will go ahead and overlay a cold start on my morning commute so you can see what it looks like when you fire the thing up at about 4 in the morning. So starting here with the air fuel ratios, these are the current targets I have set up. These may be different depending on your particular configuration of engine, but these seem to do the best for not having a lot of searching and giving me pretty good overall performance. Now, the more important one is the enrichment ratios. This took me some tinkering, but I believe this is probably the best configuration for my setup that I can come up with. I had to take everything out of the acceleration fuel simply to give it a little more throttle response when I initially stepped on it to keep it from over-richening, going from idle to transition. I then had to give it a little more fuel on cranking and cold start to get it to run well before it stepped into the maps. Otherwise, the system pretty much sorted everything else out itself. Now looking at the app here, now that it's connected up to the Bluetooth distributor, the car has to be in the on position but not running in order for you to play with these settings. So here are my current timing curves. As you can see, I come in a little early at 12 at 500, step immediately to 15 and then hold that from 700 to 1000, and then jump only to 16 at 1400. Then I go ahead and move up to 22 by 2800 and 24 by 8000. Now, the reason that these are only as low as they are, they're obviously not where it says in the manual between 32 and 36, is because I then also have it set up to have a 10 degree bump in from the map sensor. So now this is essentially like vacuum advance. So this is sort of the base timing, and then I gain 10 beyond 1500 RPM, as it states down in the lower map settings. So this gives me a pretty good curve. It runs pretty darn well. I've played with a little more and a little less timing, but ultimately this seems to do the trick for what my car can handle. I believe the car's pretty worn out as far as cam and valves go. I adjusted all the valves and got their adjustments correct, but there is a lot of wear on the cam, So I'm pretty sure that you could probably give a little bit more oomph to a warmed over engine or something with a little bit hotter cam, get a lot more performance out of it. But this keeps the noise to a minimum and I don't get any detonation or pinging, so I'm happy with it for now. When I can get it to an actual dyno, I'll go ahead and try a few more things with it. So under the hood here, you can see, looking at the new Bluetooth distributor, that the cap is in a slightly different orientation. So the cap that came with the car was oriented such that first spark plug was here. So spark plug one was up top. Now on this one's actually spark plug two, and spark plug one is down here, almost 180 degrees off. Now that caused me all kinds of problems when I was installing this, because it tries to have you install it in a very similar orientation to the factory. But really the easiest way to install this that I found was to simply stub it in here, make sure the numbers on the cap match the plug wires that you're working with, turn it until the car will kind of start, lock out the app at 10 degrees, because that's about where this car seems to actually start at, then set the timing by turning this and checking with a timing light until you see 10 degrees on the timing marks. Once you've got that set up, you can go ahead and lock this in place with the Allen screw and then do everything else from the app, and it seems to work. Also, I went ahead and installed the new coil, even though I probably didn't need to, simply because it looked like somebody else had already installed a coil that didn't use the factory resistances and probably would have worked. Now, assuming I can actually be heard over the wind here, the rest of the EFI setup is pretty straightforward. I mounted my map sensor right here for convenience. And with this, I actually rerouted the vacuum lineup to a T-fitting with my fuel pressure regulator over there. Now, that seems to be what really probably solved my stumbling issue between 2400 and 2800 RPM. Although the reinstallation of the carbon canister happened at the exact same time, so I don't know for sure. As you can see here, I reused the 90 degree elbow that was already on the intake plenum to attach my IACV, which seemed to work pretty good and keeps it from interfering with the hood. The IACV is just basically a controlled vacuum leak, which is what allows it to idle up so high when you first start the car and control the idle and cold starts and those sorts of situations. If you can see down in there, I actually took off the lower pan and had it powder coated and remounted it, which is pretty rare for these cars. Most of them don't have their belly pans in place, but now it's all nice, shiny, powder coated black. The overall installation is pretty easy. I don't like the way the wiring harnesses are run, but I haven't had time to cut and make a new wiring harness. Ultimately, I would like to cut and make a new wiring harness to simplify the way these plugs are set up, and to run with this single billet fuel rail that I have installed, get it to also more conveniently run all the wires in line with it back to the firewall with a set plug here for disconnecting the fuel injector harnesses. But that'll come at a later date when I have more time to work on it. Ultimately, I'm just happy that this system's working as well as it is, and I can definitely recommend this to other people if you're looking to simplify the configuration of your Z car and get rid of the Bosch fuel system. In true Oregonian fashion, I'm already back in the shade because I don't want to get burnt to a crisp standing out here, but I'm trying to keep this video as short as possible. So in an effort to do so, my summary would be this. The EZ EFI system is a great solution to do away with the complicated and unnecessarily finicky Bosch systems on this car. It deletes several different temperature sensors from the coolant system. It simplifies the entire installation down to a much nicer and more modern wiring harness, and it gives you a lot of flexibility for a lot of different engine configurations. This is especially true when you do what I did and move over to a single one-piece fuel rail and O-ring style injectors, which make life immensely easier than the irritating short-run injectors that come on the factory rail. The 123 Bluetooth ignition system's distributor is probably a couple hundred dollars more expensive than a comparable system you could piece together using MSD and combining it with a EFI setup such as Sniper or possibly the EZ EFI if you could find the settings to unlock. I couldn't, and everyone told me you usually probably have to step up to the next version to actually have distributor and ignition control. But ultimately, I like the 1-2-3 Bluetooth distributor simply because it gives me the ability to have an immobilizer that I can set from my phone to guarantee my car will not disappear when I'm in town late at night, since these cars can basically be opened with a screwdriver. It also gives me the peace of mind of having a modern distributor system that I don't have to second guess whenever I start to run into timing issues. So thank you all for watching. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.